Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's the 20th of December, 2012. I have some updates for you. Certainly, Christmas is almost here and Santa's coming to town. My little buddy here just helped us get it kicked off as a reminder. There was a town hall last week that was held by 7th Fleet, and I was there as well. Several issues came up. I want you to all know we are looking at them. One of them that was brought up was some of the lighting around the base. As you know, for energy conservation, we have secured quite a few of the street lights, but we might have got a little overzealous in some areas, especially around crosswalks, as you'll see there on Clement out by the NFCU. We've turned a couple of them back on. So we're taking a good look at that, and you'll see some of the street lights coming back on that were off for energy conservation, so we can try to make things a little more safer. Again, we got a little overzealous with it, but it was a good point that was brought up at the town hall, along with quite a few other ones, and we are researching and checking into everything that got brought up. A reminder that this Friday, when school lets out, it's going to be out for a little while. This is their winter break coming up. Schools will not be back in session until the 7th of January. So sorry, parents, your kids are going to be around all day, every day for the next couple of weeks. The driver's license office is going to be closed December 28th through January 3rd. That is due to the master labor contractor holiday. So if you need any services at the driver's license office, you're not going to be able to get them from the 28th of December through the 3rd of January. Christmas Day itself obviously is on Tuesday, December 25th. Got some good eats around here for some of you. Down at the USO, the new USO that just opened down there next to Fleet Rec, they'll be doing their single and unaccompanied sailor free steak and eggs breakfast that morning from 8 to 10 o'clock. So if you're a single sailor or unaccompanied, come on down, get yourself a good breakfast to start Christmas morning off with. And then over at the galley, it's going to be an open galley on Christmas Day. That runs from 1500 to 1730. Pretty good price and also a great meal. They always put on an outstanding spread for the holidays over there. Many of the clubs are open, O Club, CPO Club. Reservations are strongly encouraged if you want to do either the buffets or for brunch or the Christmas dinners there. And for anybody that's not aware of this, Chili's will be open their normal hours on Christmas Day if you want to go down and get a burrito or something instead, or enchilada or whatever they serve down there. A couple construction updates I want to talk to you about. Down at the auto port, you'll see they've started doing some conduit work. The reason for that is we're going to get new pumps at the auto port. They should be functional by May, the end of May most likely, and they're going to be the type of pumps where you can use credit cards on them, the pay at the pump pumps for the gasoline there at the auto port. We're going to be getting them here at the Yokosuka installation. A couple of paving projects going on over there behind Purdy Gym. That parking lot that was and gravel area is now being paved. That's supposed to be done by the end of this month, here in a few days. And then in January, there's going to be a project that's going to go on that's going to repave all the area around Berkey Field. The running track that we do for the PRT, that's going to be part of it. We'll plan on having that done before the spring PFA start. But if you ever ran it, many of you have ran that track, and it's cracked in places. It's got some dips. We're going to try to make it smoother and safer. Maybe you can take a few seconds off your time next year once we get the new pavement down out there. But that's coming in January. This weekend over at the O Club on Saturday from 11:30 to 1400, there's going to be the Kelly Bell Band. That is a blues band along with a magician named Michael Kent. There's first come, first serve on tickets. The tickets are free, but there's only 200 of them. And there will be a buffet you can purchase if you want to eat while you're there as well. But if you're into blues bands or magicians, opportunity at the O Club this weekend on Saturday. Lots of New Year's Eve parties being planned at all the clubs. And also I want to remind you of the Yokosuka Countdown. We're still doing the Yokosuka Countdown with the city this year, despite some of the liberty restrictions that were put in place. There will be fireworks shot off. You can probably see those from the base without problems. The countdown will occur at Verney Park. And there is waivers to the curfew, so if you want to participate in that and you're worried about the curfew, I strongly encourage you to route your request up to your chain of command. I think it'll be taken care of. You should be able to get a curfew waiver for New Year's Eve to go out to Verney Park and support the city's Yokosuka Countdown. I strongly encourage that if you're worried about going out there and you want to go out there. It's usually it's a really good event. They have food out there and vendor booths, and the mayor shows up, so I encourage supporting the Yokosuka Countdown event if you've got the time and desire to. I'd like to remind everybody about the designated driver programs on base. There's no excuse to be getting behind the wheel with ignorant oil in your system. There's plenty of ways to get around. They've even got programs that'll take you to one of the three local train stations. So please, at all our clubs, we've got designated driver programs. Please take advantage of that, especially if you've been consuming the spirits. Christmas trees. I know you just got your trees up. They look pretty and everything, but here's just a reminder on Christmas tree disposal when the time comes for it. If you live off base, please utilize the off-base residence dumpster. And if you live on base, call 243-6558 in order to arrange for collection. That is 243-6558 for collection when the time comes. Obviously, not right now. And finally, on this note, the 30th of December, the last Sunday of the month, there will be the normal demonstrations that occur by the locals down at the front gate down there at Kearney, and there'll be a waterborne one. Not expecting a large number, so we're not expecting any gate closures, but on the afternoon of the 30th of December, you will see some protesters down there. All right, on to the trivia. Y'all made this one easy on me this week because only one of the four questions I asked on my last video got answered, so I'm only going to go over that answer, and I'm just going to repeat the other three that weren't answered and see if we can get some answers this time. One of the questions I asked was, what was the only two-time Heisman Trophy winner? The answer to that is Archie Griffin out of Ohio State, and John Hicks gave the answer to that one. That one was kind of easy. Now, my other three trivia questions. What is the correct mistletoe etiquette? There's a proper way you're supposed to handle yourself under the mistletoe, so see if someone can give me that answer. For a song, yeah, here's the lyrics. Give me the title, an artist, and the movie it's from. Why have you gone away? Where is the laughter you used to bring me? Why can't I hear music play? All right. And finally, this one's fairly easy. I'm surprised I didn't get an answer on this one already. Who is Rudolph's father? You can't answer that, Santa. I know you know the answer. But who is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer's father? Okay, as a reminder to everybody, CFAY, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great holiday season, Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.